Okay, let's take this example. So now what will happen? Browser invoked. As soon as you run this line, the browser will be invoked. As soon as you run this line, it will be navigated. And the good thing about this .get is it will keep on waiting unless the page is loaded. So unless everything is like that, you know, spinning wheel is completely disappear, till then it will wait here. It will, you know, pointer will continuously be there. As soon as the page is loaded, then immediately it will try to find for this element, right? Now in this case, things are pretty simple. Why? Because it's not that rich an HTML application. It's simple. Now there can be, there is a possibility that there is an AJAX here. Even though the page is loaded, but things are still loading in the inside of the page. That is a possibility. So perhaps, you know, imagine that this click the button to display an alert box. This button is not coming. It is taking some time to appear here. Okay. But your script doesn't know that. It will immediately try to find it using these credentials. And it will not able to find it. It will immediately throw an error. No element exception. Okay. Now let's give more intelligence to it. So what we'll do, we'll say, okay, I have this assumption that within 20 seconds, it will come. So I'll write thread.sleep 20 seconds. Okay. So now what will happen? Now this will work. Okay. Because we are sure that, okay, in 20 seconds, it will come and it's coming. Your script will still work, right? But the problem with this is we are wasting some time. What if the pop-up or that button appears in 8 seconds? So how much time you're losing? 12 seconds. Now 12 seconds seems to be insignificant, but it has a huge impact when it comes to running of 20,000 test cases. Oh, sorry, 2,000 test cases. Okay, it can significantly increase your single script execution. And let's say you have done this in a common method, or you have done this in, you know, many scripts, you know, it will significantly decrease the performance of your script. That is why it is avoided. Shouldn't be using it. So it wastes time. Okay. Second best approach is, so I'll say, okay, I'll not do this. Let's do this. So now this is a better approach than this. What will happen now? It will come to this line and it will see, okay, the button is not there. Then we'll see how much is the implicit wait timeout. Let's say 20 seconds. It will say, okay, let's wait for 20 seconds. It will wait 1 second and it will check. Did button came? No. It will again wait for 1 second, then it will again check. So it continuously keeps on checking. And as soon as it gets it, it will just click on it. Element form. Right? So here, your time is not getting wasted. Okay? As soon as if it gets in, the button is appearing in 8 seconds, it will just do the job, move ahead. Okay, it will come in 12 seconds, it will still wait and move on. So you can even increase it. 30 seconds then. Okay, so here time is not getting wasted. Okay, now the third approach, which is explicit wait. Okay, let's talk about explicit wait. WebDriver wait. Wait is equal to new web driver wait. It takes basically two arguments. One, the driver, which is our driver object. And second is timeout in seconds. So I'll say 20 seconds. I'll click on it. Wait dot until. So I'm now writing explicit conditions. Okay. As I said, you need to have a condition for the synchronization. Here, what was the condition? There was no condition. Without condition, it will continuously wait. The dumbest possible way of putting a synchronization, right? It is dumb. It doesn't know anything, no intelligence. This has some level of intelligence. Unless the element appears, right? Some condition is implicit to this wait. Now, in this explicit, we need to give an explicit condition. Okay, so explicit condition is, this is how you give it. So there's a web driver object present inside Selenium jar. You make use of it, you create an object of it, you mention the driver at 20 seconds as a timeout. Then you write wait dot until. Okay, until is, as the name suggests, you're trying to put some condition, right? I'm writing until. Inside this, I'm going to create an expected condition. As soon as I do dot, here I can put some conditions. So these conditions are predefined. Selenium predefined these conditions. I can write my own conditions also. It doesn't have all the conditions possible. Right? From, for example, changing attribute from red to green. It doesn't have it. You need go and can create a function inside it. Okay, that is a bit more complex for now at least. You know, we are not going to talk about it. So here we are going to make use of it. Only the defined expected conditions. So our expected condition is alert is present. Okay. So if I let's select this, where will we use it? As soon as you do a click, this is coming almost instantly. Immediately it's coming. Instantly it's coming. What if it's not instantly coming? What if it's taking time? How can you make sure of it? Okay. So what will happen if I don't write this here? What will happen as soon as this is clicked? This click means you're clicking on this. As soon as this is clicked, what will happen? It will immediately try to do a switch. It will immediately try to do a switch and alert and do this operation. But assume, imagine that this is not coming. It will take some time to appear. So it will immediately fail. Right? That's the problem. To solve this problem, we are explicitly putting a condition here. That let's wait for after the click is performed, let's wait for this alert is present. So we are putting a condition here with a timeout. So synchronization, if you're putting implicit or explicit, there is always has to have a condition and a timeout. Right? If we don't do this, let's say, assume that this is not there. So what will happen? It will continuously wait, keep on waiting for it. We don't want it. We want time. Okay, wait karo par kab tak, right? That has to be defined. All right. So here we are putting the condition. Here we are putting the time. Clear enough? Any questions here? Right. Now, this is not the only expected condition which you have. You have lot of conditions. See. Attribute contains attribute, attributes, element selection, state to be, present, frames, invisibility, presence of, staleness, text to be, title is. Okay, let's, for example, you're clicking on something and there's a new page opening. So you can wait for title to change. As soon as title is changed, keep on waiting till that moment. Okay, so all the basic conditions are already defined by Selenium here. If these doesn't fulfill your needs, then you can go and write your own functions inside it using a functional interface concept. But you can write your own functions inside. Got it? So far so good? Questions? No questions yet?